Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for the opportunity. On behalf of my party, Telugu Desam, I rise to thank the Honorable President for his address. Ma'am, 2020 has been a very tough year for all of us. The pandemic has tried us in the hardest ways possible. I would like to appreciate the efforts of our Honorable Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi ji, and the government for managing the crisis excellently. Ma'am, I would also like to express my deepest gratitude to the frontline workers and the scientific community of the country who have come out with life-saving breakthroughs at an astounding pace. It is indeed a matter of immense pride to see the efforts of Bharat Biotech for coming out with a Made in India vaccine, ma'am. Ma'am, I would also like to state that the Genome Valley, where Bharat Biotech has done its wonders, was an initiative of my leader, Nara Chandrababu Naidu, the then Chief Minister of United Andhra Pradesh, whose vision has always been to promote and invest in scientific research to make people's lives better. Ma'am, now I would like to talk about a burning national issue, the farmers issue, ma'am. Thousands of farmers all over the country are expressing their resent over three farm laws since last few months, ma'am. Confusing stance on the MSP, the APMC mandis, and the dispute resolution mechanism have added to their grievances, had added to the grievance of the farmers, ma'am. On behalf of my party, I request the government to address these issues with an open mind and engage with the protesting farmers in a constructive manner immediately. Ma'am, now I would like to bring to the notice of this August House about the 29,000 protesting farmers who have sacrificed 33,000 acres of their valuable land on the call of our leader, Mr. Chandrababu Naidu, for the construction of the state capital, Amaravati, for which Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji laid foundation. Their protests have entered their 418th day today, ma'am. The government has used the state police to brutalize and harass these protesters. They have used all sorts of tricks on them, but have not been able to break the conviction of the farmers, ma'am. Ma'am, this three capital proposal of Mr. Jagan Reddy is an illogical innovation which the state government is hell-bent upon pursuing, ma'am. Now I would like to mention the burning issue in our state, ma'am, state of Andhra Pradesh. Ma'am, the recent decision of the Union Cabinet to privatize Visakhapatnam steel plant has invited sharp opposition from the people and also from all the political parties across the state, ma'am. Ma'am, there is a strong Telugu sentiment around Visakhapatnam steel plant, which was achieved way back in 1960s through serious protests with a slogan, Vishaka Ukku Andhra Hakku, meaning Vishaka steel is Andhra's right. Ma'am, nearly 32 people died across the state due to the police firing during the protest, and also several farmers belonging to 64 villages sacrificed 22 acres, which presently values more than 1 lakh crore rupees, ma'am. Madam, this Vishaka steel plant, which is giving employment to nearly 20,000 people directly and many thousands indirectly, was set up with an investment of 5,000 crores initially, was managing its finances perfectly, ma'am, but and never a burden to the central government. In return, it paid over 40,000 crores in the form of taxes since its inception, ma'am. Sir, our Chief Minister remained silent on this issue after writing an eyewash letter to the center. Hence, in this regard, I request the Honorable Prime Minister and the Finance Minister through you that the Government of India should roll back the decision, as there is no rationale in privatizing Vishaka steel plant, which is the pride of Andhra Pradesh, and I also request for the allotment of captive mines for Vishaka steel plant, which will help in bringing the plant into profits. Sir, time and again our party has raised issues Andhra Pradesh has been facing since its bifurcation. It is no different this time. The promises of AP Bifurcation Act 2014 remain unfulfilled and unforgotten.
Mr. Srinivas, just a moment. Which rule are you quoting?
352.
Just a moment. Yes, tell me.
152.
रूल बुक दे दो।
सर एंड इट इज नॉट फैक्चुअल सर, वी हैव ऑलरेडी रिप्रेजेंटेड, ही इज कॉलिंग द लेटर ऑफ आवर ऑनरेबल चीफ मिनिस्टर एज एन आई वन एंड इट इज नॉट, ही इज नॉट एंटाइटल्ड टू डू दैट, दिस शुड बी एनफोर्स्ड सर एंड अर्लियर ऑल्सो ही इज रेफर्ड एंड ही हैज spoken about the chief minister with respect to the state capital, it was assembly decision and he can't mention about that here sir.
The chair will go through the speech and if found not as per the rules will be deleted.
Thank you.
The promises of AP Bifurcation Act 2014 remain unfulfilled and unforgotten. There is no mention of railway zone, no physical deficit relief, no funding for 7 backward districts, no funding for construction of Polavaram project, no Kadapa steel plant, no Digarajapatnam port, and the list can go on. Sir, the special category status was granted to Andhra Pradesh during the bifurcation. The present chief minister and his party came to power promising the people of Andhra Pradesh that they were elected to power, they would get the special category status along with the pending bifurcation promises to the state, sir. But sir, Mr. Jagan Reddy has kept quiet even after the finance ministry has categorically denied the special category status to the state, sir. This silence is a proof that he has forgotten all the promises he has made to the people of Andhra Pradesh, sir.
In this regard, please allow me to speak, sir.
The ruling party, YCP.
The ruling party, YCP,
is leading the people towards a debt trap, sir,
which has risen by 115
lakh crores in just 20 months, sir.
Mithunji, I have already said, we will go through the speech. Chair will go through the speech. Yes, Mr. Srinivas.
It is not acceptable by us.
The whole speech will be read through.
Sir, the ruling party YCP is leading the people towards a debt trap which has risen by 1,15,000 crores in just 20 months, sir, while filling their own pockets, sir. We have become the state with a maximum borrowing and a minimum development under YCP government, sir. Sir, it is not just the finances that are bad, sir. Mr. Jagan Reddy has been undermining any state functionary that does anything contrary to his wishes.
Please do
he
not.
He has brazenly undermined the judiciary.
Please do
and
not
the election
quote
commission.
The name who is not present in this house.
The law and order situation in the state has
just
gravely deteriorated in the last 20 months, sir. Mr. Jagan Reddy has made his message clear.
Please don't quote the name.
It is his way or the highway.
That will not be under.
This is not how our great democracy is supposed to function, sir. I sincerely wish and hope that my state, Andhra Pradesh, see better days in future, sir. Sir, with this, I conclude my speech, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.